Alright guys, oh let me fix the resolution. Okay, so this time we are gonna tackle Tentu from the Tower of Conquest, and I just wanna not Tentu but 9-2, sorry, and I just wanna show you my team first. So first of all, this guy, we need to bring him. Why? Because we need to tank the range damage. There is no way around it. At least I don't find any. That's why I decided, okay, since I cannot avoid it, I might as well just tank them. So there are two archers in the map, and this guy will tank both of them. I give him as much beef as I can. So even if you don't have this newborn blade here, just give him something that will basically reduce the physical damage. So maybe this dueling dagger seems like it will be amazing actually. Maybe I should just use this instead of this one. But this is what I used. But keep in mind, you just need to give him basically as much physical damage defense and also as much physical damage that can decrease as possible. Also give him this unique code because of that. And also, since I won't be bringing any healer, I bring this Tarot Whisper here of the Moon. Recovers 20% HP if the character is injured. So that's our tank. The second one, which is very very important on this run, is gonna be Nightingale. So I bring Nightingale. She is not really geared, but what you will need is really just the Burning Grenade whip and Weapon Eroder. Because the range of Weapon Eroder will be amplified because of the stage rules. So that's why you're gonna want to bring this Nightingale. And also the Burning Grenade just give us basically Burning Tiles will limit their movement a lot, and it will also damage them a lot. So we wanna bring her. And for the Burning Grenade, she will unfortunately need to be rank 7 at least, so yeah. And then I bring, who else I'm bringing? Yeah, of course, I'm bringing the gang, but only one of them this time, because I don't have any spot left. So I only bring the Veldiren's Code, because I see some guy say it on my YouTube comment, okay, they don't have the Outlaw Assassin. But keep in mind, if you don't have the Veldiren's Code, you can replace her very easily with the Outlaw Assassin. So these two are interchangeable. So basically, either this one or this one. You just want them to have one Noxious Shrapnel, and that will be enough. Maybe the Outlaw Archer can work too, if in case you don't have both of them. But yeah, you get the gist of it. And then we wanna bring this guy too. Where are you? The Outlaw, yeah, the Recruited Assassin. I think maybe we don't need him, but no, I think we need him. So yeah, so I bring him for defensive footwork for dodge. If you don't have him somehow, maybe you can bring Blade, because Blade also has defensive footwork. But yeah, I think this one more people will have him, because he is a common unit. So yeah, that's the Recruited Assassin. And yeah, let's see, Recruited Assassin, Nightingale, Veldiren's Code, that's 3 Papal Pikeman, and also I think I'm missing one more. Who is it? Yeah, of course, Stinger. Sorry. So you really want to bring Stinger here, and keep in mind you have to have this setup here. So I think I found that this trait really helps me finish off dying enemies, the Luxed Shrapnel, and also Infected Dagger. That's what I'm bringing on my Stinger. And for the Papal Guard, if you see here, his skills needs to be this 4. I don't know if any other skills can work, but this is what I bring. And and here, I have both of these, right? Plagilan and Invulnerable. And I use my Castalia for that. But during the run, you will see that Papal Guard tank everything like a boss anyway. So I have a feeling really that she might not need one of them. So I think what you want is just Invulnerable, because Invulnerable will be used on one of the weapon trial stage if you want to push that too. So I think you're better off with Invulnerable. Just activate it if when you feel like, okay, this turn I will take a lot of damage. And when you bring Invulnerable, most likely you won't have this, right? You won't have the Flagellant. So you will want to replace Flagellant with this one here, because you want to take the heavy armor, defense range attack, and invulnerable. So that's what I would bring. pelajaran might be useful, but I'm more afraid that honestly, I think either of them would be fine. That's what I would say. But because if vulnerable is used in one of the weapon trial, most likely this is what you want. So yeah, that's our tip. And yeah, keep in mind, I give my papal god, yeah, the moon once again, just so that he can heal by himself. And also the recruited assassin, I give him this one, guidance of the world, so that he can regen energy to use fancy footwork to dodge. So yeah, without further ado, let's see how I do my stage. Yeah, I don't really do it live because unfortunately I use a lot of backtrack. I think this is gonna be better if I show it this way. So yeah, this is how I set them up. And as for tactics, you want to bring the teleport one and the barrel one, the explosive barrel and also the maneuver command. So yeah, throwing Luxit shrapnel right at the beginning. Here I believe I use one of his skill right there. Yeah, the infected dagger, I use it on this guy here because I want to kill him. Throwing the burning grenade here. Here I put defensive stance on him, this skill right here, and also teleport the Nightingale back. Because otherwise she will be hit. Yeah, good. Here I put my assassin there dodging. Throw away another flask of Luxit shrapnel, and there without the trait this guy won't die. So the passive and trait. So this passive here is very, very important. Wait a minute, I need to click something, I think. Can you be gone, please? Maybe when it's my turn. Hey, you. Can I? Yeah, now it's gone. Sorry. Okay. So yeah, I think I throw the weapon eroder. Yes. So I use weapon eroder on this guy here. Why? Because I think this guy is one of the most dangerous opponent on the battlefield with his threat here, which can kill you if you are not careful. So I throw it here because this guy will change to a bear anyway, and I won't be able to kill him before he changes to a bear. So I decided, okay, why not just use it on him? And weapon eroder can reach because of the stage rule that increased the range by 2 tiles. And here I decide to hit that. Hit both of them, a little bit cheap damage. That guy turned into a bear, decided to move there. And here, it's very important Valerian Scott stands here, otherwise this ninja can hop into the other ledge. I use dodge there. Stinger just stand there. And here, yeah, you can see his threat is very dangerous. And here, he decided to target my assassin. Assassin just dodging. And here is the reason why I bring the Papal Pike. Papal God. Because I need someone to block this choke point here. And I believe if you just use the Recruit Assassin to dodge, it won't be enough. Because you will be hit by these 2 archers every turn. Throwing Luxit shrapnel. Dodging again. Yeah, I'll just go back because I don't want to be targeted. As you can see, the Papal God tank the damage like there is no tomorrow. So yeah, throw the shrapnel again. Now that I think about it, maybe I don't need this. No, it will be more convenient actually. So once again, I kill that guy with the passive. Here I'm just tanking with my Papal God. Yeah, you're gonna be fine with either Fragilan only or the other. Use Armor Eroder there. Armor Eroder. So yeah, just thinking on the papal guard. I think about it, maybe we don't need the papal guard actually, because this guy here, I think he can just no, not really. The energy will not be enough. Yeah, it's fine. Just thinking how we can do it better. I decided to destroy the barrel there because I want to put a new barrel soon to kill both of the archers here. And here I throw another shrapnel on them. Just wait, and I blink with stinger here, put the barrel down here, throw the shrapnel there, and kill both of them. Good. Good. And here is my only mistake that I wish I could have fixed. So I ran out of backtrack here. So I put my ninja here and then put a barrel here, right? Yeah. But actually what you wanna do is actually put your ninja here and the barrel here, because if your ninja is here, this guy will move here and do his charge attack. I wish he would hit me with normal attack so I can dodge it, but that's not what happened. And before I backtrack, I tried putting the barrel in the place of the assassin here and the recruited assassin here. And it ends up better because this guy is stuck here just waiting for his death. But because I move that way, something else will happen. Okay. And there another one. So 3 kills with his passive alone. As you can see, it's very important. And yeah, he does his charge attack in this direction, which I'm really pissed off about. But yeah, what can you do? Throwing armor eroder there once again. And finally I hit that. Throw the shrapnel, the barrel explode, and he dies. Even if he doesn't die there, your stinger will kill him next turn. So yeah, I just think I could have won it without losing any unit there, actually, if I'm more careful, but yeah, it's fine. Yeah, good luck, guys.